All right, people, what is up and welcome back. So we're about to head out and do a little bit of sheepshead fishing, but before we get into it, I want to show you all the rig that we're gonna be using today. Super simple, probably the easiest and most convenient way to catch sheepshead. And that's gonna be just a single drop rig. So all we have right here is a swivel sinker, a circle hook, and some 20 pound fluorocarbon leader. Super simple. So we're gonna show you how we tie this up, and then we're gonna roll some clips of us out there catching them. All right, so to start on this rig, all we're gonna do is take our swivel sinker right here and tie it onto the bottom of our line. So, you don't have to tie a real good knot. We just do a double knot, that's it. A little bit through. Don't even have to worry about the tag ends. They aren't very picky. Boom. Then from there, we're gonna run up about a foot and just do a double knot again. So put the line in our hands, two of them. And oop, if I can grab this. Okay. All right, now we're just gonna loop it through the hole twice. Two or three times, whatever you want. Just right now, I'm gonna do it twice. And then we just pull tight. And next thing, we put on our hook and we're done. All you do is just pinch the end, run your hook through it, pull it over, and then put it over your hook. Just like if you've seen our video where we're making tandem rigs for flounder, it's pretty much the same thing, except we tie the knots a little bit differently, but the hook and the weight are the same. So what we like to do is we don't tie a swivel right here. What we do is we'll just make our leader like 6 feet long, and then we'll just tie it straight to our line with the leader knot. We'll put a video up right here that will show you exactly how to tie that forward to braid. But yeah, that's what we do. And then whenever we break off, you usually just lose your weight, and then you can just cut it, retie up, so then you don't have to keep on tying leader line or keep on, you know, losing swivels and all of your gear. You can just keep tying it up the leader until you're out. So that's it right there, guys. Hope you all enjoy the clips of us catching these fish, and then we'll see y'all back in the kitchen to cook it up.
All right, guys, what is up and welcome back. Today we're out here doing a little bit of sheepshead fishing because we had so much fun doing it last time. We got one right there. 15. It's a keeper going in the cooler. Hopefully we can get some more. Nolan is on. Bro, you got one. A good one. A really good one. Hold on, guys. I got to put my rod down and get a net. Nolan's got a good fish. What is it? Probably a redfish. He just came up. What is that? It's a redfish, huh? Yeah, guys, we're battling. No, it's a big sheepshead. Dude, he's tangled. That's your problem. There, look at that. Bring him this way. All right. Another keeper. That one's bigger. Probably 16, 17.
All right, guys, we just measured him right here. 17, so he's going to go on the stringer. Let's get some more.
All right, so all we're doing here, we got a 3/4 ounce weight. The weight depends on the current. We don't have too much current, so 3/4 ounce is plenty. And then a circle hook about a foot up. Shrimp hooked right through the head or to the tail, whichever you like. And just fill it to structure. So here, so all we're doing is just casting up under the structure. Letting it sink and hit the bottom and keeping our line pretty tight so we don't get snagged. Then we just wait for a couple bites, let them chew on it for a second, and then you just set the hook.
Nolan is on once again. Sheepshead? Didn't need a net, or can you just grab him? You probably just grab the line, huh? Yeah, he's probably like 13.
Well, we only ended up with two sheepshead today because the bite was pretty slow and the current just wasn't moving much. But here's one of them right here that Nolan caught. I think it's probably about 17 inches. And then I caught one that was about 15 and a half. So we're just gonna be making super simple whole baked sheepshead. I've never done this before, but I mean, how hard can it be, right? So what we're gonna start off doing is just taking a scaler. You can get these for, I'm pretty sure, like a dollar at Academy. And we're just gonna start by rubbing it to break through, cause I already did this, to be honest with y'all. And it's pretty hard to just start off scaling it. So just rub it back and forth real quick and it'll break through. And the scales are gonna go everywhere. So just be prepared. Do it outside. You could also use a spoon, which might actually be easier on a sheepshead. So we're just gonna do this all over the fish. Then we're gonna take the guts out, and that's it. Throw it in the oven, put a little bit of seasoning on it, maybe some lemons. All right, so we got this thing all scaled up, nice and good, as you can see. And it's pretty neat how it still has its colors from its skin underneath it. I just find that cool. So what we're gonna do now is we're just gonna take out the gut. So we're just gonna start right in between these two fins right here, poke in and run it down to the butt. That's cut. Now we just open it up, put your hand in there, and pull all the guts out. Make sure it's all nice and cleaned out. there's shrimp, and then we'll see y'all inside. All right, we got our fish all scaled right here. One thing I forgot to tell y'all is that once y'all are done scaling it and ripping out all the guts, take your water hose and put it up in the cavity right here, up in the stomach, and just spray it out, get all that blood and stuff out of there. So now what we're gonna do, super simple, we're just gonna take our knife and we're just gonna score it down to the backbone. So, just cut through, just like that. Make a few of those. And I might've cut through a little bit much on that first one, obviously, so not gonna do that down here. But I make about four of those, and then we do the same thing on the other side. All right, so we made our cuts down this way, now we're gonna flip around, do a couple the other way, so just like that. Kind of like we're making a bunch of X's all over it. All right, now the fish is ready to be seasoned. So we moved them over to the tray now, and we're gonna season it up. So all I got right here is avocado oil that I put some Hungarian paprika in, a little bit of other seasoning, and I don't remember the other thing, to be honest with you, I completely forgot. So we're just gonna fold them like this, so the oil gets all in there. This is gonna keep them from sticking, it's also gonna keep them moist, and it just helps get that seasoning everywhere. So, like that, rub it in, make sure it gets all in the cracks. Just like that. Let me flip them over, same thing on the other side. Rub it in, spread around evenly. All right, and now we're gonna season them up, a little bit of salt. Same thing on the other side. And a little bit of pepper. Super simple. More right there. And then to finish them off, we got some lemons here. So we're gonna stuff a couple of them up inside of his stomach, just like that. And then we will lay some on top of him for when he goes in the oven. Like boom, we'll do that and that. And this thing is gonna be delicious. So we got the oven set to 375. We're about to put them in there and let them cook. Probably take about 25 minutes, I would guess. Then we'll pull them out and tell you exactly how he tastes. We got the whole fish here, looks great. Put a nice little sauce on it. It was like a buttery mustard lemon sauce. I have no idea, honestly, no one just told me to make it. So here we go, we have it. We're gonna give it a taste. Oh, white and flaky. I don't know if you can see that. You gotta look right there. Smells good, I'll tell you what. Let's try it. All right, I gotta be honest with you guys. This is some of the best fish I've ever had. We're definitely gonna be doing this again. I'm gonna go in for a whole nother bite in just a second. But first, thank y'all so much for watching. I hope y'all enjoyed. Hit that like button, leave a comment, and make sure to subscribe if you are not already. And if you are, thank you so much. And until next time, people, peace.